Shalom, shalom. It's Tehillah from the Kfar with our bi-weekly Hebrew verbs lesson. So we are continuing on with the PL Binyan. We're still doing the present tense, and we're going to learn another conjugation pattern using the verb that means to wait. But as usual, we're going to start with a review of the exercise verbs that I gave you in the last lesson when we learned about the acha PL verbs. And these are verbs where the middle letter of the shoresh is an aleph, hey, chet, or ayin. So similar concept that we saw in the pa'al verbs. There's a similar sound pattern when it comes to the conjugation with the pl verbs. So we use the verb lesachek in the last lesson, which means to play. And your first exercise verb was leta'er, which is to describe. So when you get rid of the lamed, that gives us our shoresh of ti'er, taf aleph resh. So, meta'er, masculine singular, meta'eret, feminine singular, meta'arim, masculine plural, and meta'arot, feminine plural. And so you see with the plurals, we have an additional a sound because that middle letter, in this case, is an aleph. But if the middle letter is an aleph, hey, chet, or ayin, then we have that additional a sound underneath the middle letter in the plurals, both the plural masculine and plural feminine. The second verb was lemaher, which is to hurry. Get rid of the lamed. Miher is our root. Memaher, masculine singular. Memaheret, feminine singular. Memaharim, masculine plural. And memaharot, feminine plural. And here we have the two groups side by side. So with our regular PL verbs, essentially what we're doing is we're replacing the lamed in the infinitive with the mem when we're doing our conjugations. So we go from levashel, to cook, to mevashel, and then mevashelet, mevashlim, and mevashlot. And then for our acha PL verbs, again, the masculine and the feminine singular stay the same, just like the regular verbs. So we go from lesachek, to play, to mesachek, play, masculine singular, mesacheket, feminine singular. And then for the masculine and feminine plural, in place of the shva, we have an additional a sound. Mesachakim instead of mesachkim, and mesachakot instead of mesachkot. All right, so those are the two PL groups that we've done so far. And now we are going to add a third group that, again, if you started from the beginning and you watched all of the Pa'al videos, it will be familiar to you. And this is the Vav Tav group. And these are groups, or PL verbs rather, where the infinitive ends in a Vav Tav. So again, this was the same third pa'al verb lesson that we did. So you probably already have an idea of how we're going to find the root. It's going to be the same process that we took with the pa'al verbs. So we're going to use the verb lechakot. And lechakot, here it is with the vowels, means to wait. So this is the infinitive. Like, I don't want to wait for you. Lechakot. So the first step, you know, as always, is to get rid of that initial lamed. And the second step, we see here that it ends in a vav tav. So we're going to convert that vav tav to a hey. And that gives us a root of chika. And this is a vav tav verb. All right? Now, here we see that it's going to be, again, a very similar sound pattern to the pa'al verbs. The vav tav pa'al verbs. However, we have that initial mem in the front that we see is characteristic of pl verbs, like we had mevashel, mesachek, meta'er, mevashlim, mevashelet, etc. Okay, so the pl verbs, when we're conjugating them in the present tense, they start with an initial mem. So for masculine singular, our sound pattern is m-a-e. Okay, m-a-e, very similar to the masculine singular sound patterns of the first two PL groups. Feminine singular is m-a-a. Okay, so m-a-e, masculine singular, m-a-a, feminine singular. For the masculine and the feminine plural, you'll notice that we only have two of the white boxes, and that's because the hey of the shoresh is going to drop out, just like it did with the pa'al verbs, okay? So we're only going to have those first two letters of the shoresh and not the final hey. So our masculine plural sound pattern is m'a'im, and feminine plural is m'a'ot. All right, so now let's plug in the letters of our shoresh. So for masculine singular, we have m'cha-ke. Okay, so m'a'e, with our shortish, we have m'chake. Feminine singular, m'chaka. Same spelling, there's a difference in the vowel sound underneath the kaf. So m'chake, masculine singular, m'chaka, feminine singular. Masculine plural, m'chakim. And here again, you see that that final hey drops out. M'chakim. And feminine plural, m'chakot, also does not have the final hey. So m'chake, m'chaka, m'chakim, m'chakot. And now let's do it with our pronouns. So hu m'chake, he is waiting or he waits. He m'chaka, she is waiting or she waits. Like I would say, ani m'chaka, I'm waiting. A male might say, ani m'chake, I am, again, waiting, masculine. Anachnu mechakim, we are waiting or we wait. And this is masculine plural, so either a mixed group is talking or just a group of males. And hen mechakot, they, feminine plural, are waiting or they wait. All right, so now I'm going to show you the verbs side by side. We have our regular group that we went over in the beginning. We have our acha group. This is when the middle letter of our root is aleph, hey, chet, or ayin. And then we see the difference in the masculine and the feminine plural. We have a, an additional a sound in the middle instead of the shva. So we go from mevashlim and mevashlot to mesachakim and mesachakot. And now with this additional third group, the vav-tav group, when the infinitive ends in a vav-tav, we convert the final vav-tav to a hey to get the last letter of our root. And then our sound pattern is ma'a'e, ma'a'a, ma'a'im, and ma'a'ot. Like in this case, m'chake, m'chaka, m'chakim, and m'chakot. All right, so as usual, your exercise for this week is to use what you learned with the vowel or the sound patterns for PL Vav Tav verbs. So these are verbs where the infinitive ends in a Vav Tav, and you're going to conjugate these two verbs. So your first verb is legalot, and legalot is to reveal or to uncover. And the second verb is lekavot, and lekavot is to hope. Okay, so you have legalot and lekavot as your exercise verbs until we get into our next video. And in the next lesson that we do is going to be a review of these three PL forms that we've done so far. Okay, so we'll do a review with the next lesson, and then we'll continue on with additional PL patterns following that. So that wraps it up for this week. Thank you for watching. If you want to take your Hebrew learning further, feel free to reach out to me via email or check out the website, thekefar.com/Hebrew, to see whether it's a boot camp that you want to take or a Hebrew reading course or private lessons. As always, I'm open to your feedback. You can leave them in the comments below if you have any questions about the video, the PL verbs, or any of the verb videos that we've done so far. All right, until next time. Shalom.